Welcome back to the show. Alex Trebek has been the host of America's favorite quiz show for over 20 years. He doesn't have much time to talk about himself on the show. He's too busy tossing out one clue after another. But while he was here in Pittsburgh, I got a chance to sit down with Jeopardy's host and got him to reveal a little bit about me off camera, Alex. You've been with the show many years. You are the host and arguably the star, but the show is also
the
contestants are the stars. You consider yourself a steward of this special show that started years ago with Art Fleming and now continues with you.
I have, since day one, and on day one I produced the show, I have always insisted that I always be introduced as the host of Jeopardy, never the star of Jeopardy, because the stars of Jeopardy are the contestants and the material, because that's what people at home watch. I'm there as a traffic cop. I'm there to make things easier for the contestants to take our money. And we're happy when they take us for a lot of money. And over a long period of time, I'm hoping that the people will take me into their hearts and understand my weird sense of humor. I don't have to score on every program by coming up with a funny line or whatever. I'm going to be there tomorrow and next week and the following week. We've been renewed until 2010. So I may be around for a lot longer than some people would like, but I'll be here.
And as a Channel 11 employee, I'm glad to hear that. Those who work on the show say, if you see him on TV, very professorial, very bright, quick, witty, you're not exactly that guy behind the scenes.
No, I'm not.
No, I'm not. Who are you behind the scenes?
Oh, I tend to fool around a lot. I love humor. I love just kicking back. The most dressed up I ever get is when I'm on the program, or unless I'm attending some kind of a formal event. Most of the time I'm in jeans, t-shirt, I'm fixing things around the house, and it's fun. I love it. I'm more comfortable in a hardware store than I am in a television studio, I think. So I know where to look for the bargains. I know what tools I need, and there aren't too many that I need. A wood-turning lathe or a metal-turning lathe would be something that might pique my interest about now, but nothing else that I can think of.
Under the heading, then, of might be surprised to know this, as we sit in this studio here, behind the scenes, what would people be surprised to know about Jeopardy that they don't see on TV?
Well, we are sticklers for propriety, for fair play, and for confidentiality surrounding our material. The contestant department has absolutely no contact with our writers and researchers. They are two separate departments. They are in different buildings, and never the twain shall meet. The security of the material is very, very high. We could turn some of our people loose at airports, and they would do an excellent job immediately. They are that good. And in terms of verifying the material, we are also very good. And during the course of the game, for instance, you won't see this at home because there will be a stop in play while we verify a response given by a contestant, something that we hadn't anticipated. And then we'll verify it to our satisfaction and to the satisfaction of the player. We continue and we make a slight correction on air. You'll hear me say that the judges have conferred and we have found that your response was acceptable, even though it wasn't the one we were hoping for. And then we move on.
Alex, it's great to talk to you. Welcome to Pittsburgh. I hope you've enjoyed yourself here, and we'll have a great show.